Hi, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to quickly show you how you can expand your image to cover your page and also to add a little bit of text. So in order to add an image, go up to Insert, go to Pictures, click on the drop down, and you can either select from any of these options. Picture from file is obviously the ones on your computer, and the stock images which we'll use are just part of the software. So I'm just going to select this image here, just click on the tick and click Insert. Once your image is inserted, you'll find that you can't actually move this image around. It just clicks back to its original position. In order to fix that, you can right click, go down to Wrap Text, and then go down to In Front of Text. Or you can go to Picture Format. If Picture Format isn't there, it's because you haven't selected your image. So if I click off, you can see Picture Format has disappeared. If I click on the picture, Picture Format appears, go along to Wrap Text here, click on the drop down, do exactly the same, just click In Front of Text. And now you can move this image anywhere in your document. Now, in order to stretch this out, all I need to do is to grab the corner, the cursor changes, just grab and pull out that image. And then, of course, you can put it anywhere you want. Now, of course, most landscape images won't work if you're in portrait and vice versa, but on the odd occasion, when you've only got something perhaps in the middle, then it will work fine. Just stretch it out. If I want to put some text up here, I'm going to use a text box. So go to Insert, Text Box, click on the drop down and select Draw Text Box. Then all you do is just click and drag out a text box. It doesn't matter how big or small it is at the moment because you can change it. So what we're going to do is just to add some text. Now, in order to customize this, I'm just going to select the text, go to the Home tab. I'm going to go to the font size here and just increase the font size to 20. Then I'm going to change my font. Just click on the font tab, click on the drop down, and then obviously we can go down and select a font of our choice. Let's choose this one. To make that text a little bit bigger, I'm going to use this tool here, which is increase font size. And all you need to do is just keep clicking on this until that font size reaches the size you want. Now, at the moment, you can see we've got a black border and a white background to this text box, which we need to get rid of, and that's quite easy. Select it, go to Shape Format, go to Shape Fill here, click on the drop down and select No Fill. Go to Shape Outline, click on the drop down and select No Outline. And then if I click away, you can see that we've just got that transparent text box. Now, if you'd like to add more text and you want to move it around and you want to have the same font, etc., all you need to do is copy and paste this text box. The easiest way to do that is to simply select it, hold down your Alt or Option key, my cursor changes, click and drag. But of course, you can go to the old-fashioned way of Command and Control C, Command and Control V, or go to the Home tab, and obviously you've got Copy here, click away, paste, and you've got another one. Let's just change this text. You can select it all by Command or Control A, which selects all of your text. Going to decrease the font size of this a little bit. There we go. And you can move this anywhere you like. Move all that down a little bit. If you want to add some graphics or some lines here, you can go to Insert, Shapes, click on the drop down, and you can just insert a line here. Just click and drag out a line. Now, by default, my line is blue. I'm going to change that. I'm going to select it, go to Shape Format, and go over to Format Pane here. Now, in the Format Pane menu, you've got this bucket icon. If you go to Line, click on the drop down, you've got Solid Line here, and you've got all of your colors here. If you click on the drop down, I'm just going to select black. And then in the width here, I'm just going to select one and press enter. And then I can move this line anywhere I like in my document. Just click on it. Then I can use my arrow keys So move that around. If it moves a little bit too much, you can hit your control and your command or control key, and then move your arrow keys, and then the increments won't be quite so big. You can also adjust your line. Just click on the green balls at the end and you can just adjust the width if you like, or its orientation. So once you're happy with that, you can go ahead and print it out or send it as a PDF. All you need to do is go to File, Save As, then select where you want to save it, go down to this menu here, and then just simply go down to PDF, and then just simply click Export. If I open that PDF, you can see how my PDF has turned out. Perfect. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please subscribe and have a great day.